sponsors for this church year, no? And our church year starts at June to May next year. So kita nagasugod sa January, no? And so we're so happy to have these newly elected officers. We have been praying for them before they were elected, and we believe that this is the result of our prayers, no? And so happy to have them with us. And also, we're so happy to have friends and visitors who have come for the first time, no? Nagkakalipay kita to welcome every one of you. This is our joint worship service, no? Our 7 o'clock, which is an Ilonggo worship, gina-join naton diri sa 9:30 so that we can have an ample time to fellowship with one another, to get to know each other, no? We're so happy to do that. Nagadayaw kita sa Ginoo. I do not know, ushers, if we have some visitors who have come for the first time. We would like to welcome all of you. We're so happy to have you with us, no? Okay. Sige, no? Okay, from Sibalom Antique, Sibalom Evangelical Church, we're so happy to have Lily Manipula. Din si Lily, can you please stand, Lily, together with Arlene May Mampula and Asial Mampula, no? Mampula, no? They're at the back. Ah, okay, nag-Sunday school. Okay. So we would like to welcome all of you. Iban pag-give yung mga ushers, no? Sige. So nami again, if we can all stand and worship and welcome one another, no, makanta kita sa atong welcome song even as we go around and welcome one another, okay? So we do that. Okay, so libot kag magpangamusta.
Welcome to the family. We're glad that you have come to share your life with us. As we grow in love, and may we always speak to you what God would have us be. A family always there to be strong and to lean on. May we learn to love each other more with each new day. May words of love be on our lips in everything we say. May the Spirit melt our hearts and teach us how to pray, that we might be a true family. Welcome to the family. We're glad that you have come to share your life with us. As we grow in love, and may we always speak to you what God would have us be. A family always there to be strong and to be. To be strong and to lean on. To be strong and to lean on.
Okay, so you can take your seats. Salamat gid. We hope and pray we'll extend this hands clap of fellowship even after the worship service. No? As what I've said, this is a special Sunday for us because this will be, we'll be installing our newly elected officers. No? Kagang atong installation is the first part of the worship. So those newly elected officers, can you please come forward? Can you sit in the front area so that it will not be hard for you to come at the front? Okay, so again, we would like to welcome all of you. And also, we hope and we pray that our worship service will indeed bring honor and glory to the Lord. So let us now prepare our hearts and minds as we come to worship the Lord. Okay?
Come, come praise the eternal God. Let all that is within us, body, emotions, mind, and will, praise God's holy name. Despite our failures, He forgives and releases us. More than any physician, He heals our diseases. We are hungry and weak. He fills us with good and beautiful things, satisfying our needs and restoring our strength. So come, come praise the eternal God. Sing songs from a grateful heart and remember all that He has done for us. Let us pray. We rejoice and praise Your holy name today, O Lord. As we stand before You, we feel that Your love has encouraged us to come to You with honesty and truth. This is a special day for all of us, a day to celebrate Your goodness and faithfulness. Rest assured us that Your holy presence will be with us as we worship, glorify, and honor Your holy name. Give us the pure grace of Your forgiveness and renew our hearts for the service of Your kingdom. Through Jesus Christ, love and grace, we pray. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, world without end. Amen. Amen.
So this time I call on the chairman of the Nomalik to please come and announce the newly elected officers of our church for this church year. No? And as your name are being called, will you please come here at the front for the installation?
Good morning, everyone. Last Sunday, we conducted our election of officers of the University Church. And the following personalities, or the following persons, were elected. For our moderator, Reverend Dr. Nathaniel Pobula. For our council member at large, Engineer Jose Rizal D. Harder. For our Board of Deacons, we have Mr. Emmanuel Bautista, Mrs. Nelly Fontezza, Mrs. Rose Madero, Ms. Elenel Ademdi, and Ms. Alisa P. Alisa Garcia. For our Board of Fellowship, elected were Mr. Delchar, Jesse Delchar Janala, and Ms. Carolyn Harder. For our Board of Stewardship, we have Mrs. Feli Armadelio and Miss Teresa Candido. For our Board of Christian Education, we have Mrs. Mary Jane Harder and Remedios Alog. And for our Board of Mission and Evangelism, we have Mrs. Rona Edemni and Seni Hoyo. By the way, we counted the votes last Sunday evening together with Brother Sok Ramirez and witnessed by the members of the stewardship because we counted it downstairs. And together with two daughters of mine, Linda Sue Joso and Maver Imanga. And the members of Namelec are the Sini Huyo Gani sa elected si Sini Kumari, you are elected as a Board of Mission and Evangelism members. The members of the Namelec are Mr. Sok Ramirez, Mrs. Janala Charlotte, Mrs. Tessa Militar, Mr. Carl Parillion, and yours truly. I hope and pray that more members of this church will continue to commit themselves to work and to commit themselves in the glory of God for the University Church as servants of the Lord. Thank you and God bless.
To the elected officers or to the elders, here's the word of God for you. In 1 Peter chapter 5, verses 1 to 4, it says, "To the elders among you, I appeal as a fellow elder and a witness of Christ, suffering, who also will share in the glory to be revealed. Be shepherds of God's flock that is under your care, watching over them not because you must, but because you are willing, as God wants you to be, not pursuing dishonest gain, but eager to serve, not lording it over those entrusted to you, but being examples to the flock. And when the chief shepherd appears, you will receive the crown of glory that will never fade away." And when the chief shepherd appears, he will do that. So as to the leaders, as leaders of this church, you are expected to be an example to God's people in purity of motives, conduct, values, and relationship. To follow Christ, our Lord, in His self-giving servant leadership, serving rather than being served. To teach God's word, whether in private or in public, convenient or inconvenient, and to bring God's sheep to the chief shepherds in intercessory prayer. My question is, do you now make this commitment in the presence of God and in this congregation? Okay, so will you please read or you make your pledge at this very moment? Begin.
Thank you.
Join me even as we pray for our leader. Shall we all stand for this prayer? Lord, it has pleased you to choose and put these your servants into position of leadership in your church. Enable them, Father, to faithfully fulfill the responsibilities of their office, to be worthy examples to your people, to humbly do works of service, to be ready teachers of your word, and to intercede by name for those you have put under their care, in order that the work of your church and establishment of your kingdom may greatly prosper and your name will truly be honored. Lord, I just pray for your special anointing and blessing to be upon our leaders. I pray, Lord, that you will continue to bless them with their desire to know you more, even as they study your word, and even as they spend more time in prayer in their personal life. Lord, we look forward for a great church, that you will be using this church to bring about honor and glory to your name, and especially to bring a lot of souls to your feet. We commit these leaders to your care. This is our prayer in the mighty name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Amen. As you begin your leadership, here is God's word for you. You then, my son, being strong in the grace that is in Jesus Christ, and the things you have heard me say in the presence of many witnesses, entrust to reliable people who will also be qualified to teach others. Join with me in suffering like good soldiers of Christ. 2 Timothy 2, 1-3. And also in 2 Timothy 2:15, do your best to present yourself to God as one approved, a worker who does not need to be ashamed, and who correctly handles the word of truth. Thank you very much and congratulations. A round of applause for our newly elected officers.
Oh, may I invite you to stand again, please, as we declare all together the things that God has done. Shall we begin? Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless His holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits. Who gives all our iniquities, who heals all our diseases, who redeems our life from destruction, and crowns us with loving kindness and tender mercies. The God of Abraham is our God. We will praise Him.
The God of I bow and bless the
Because of his great love for us, God, who is rich in mercy, made us alive with Christ, even when we were dead in transgressions. It is by grace we have been saved.
Thank you, Father, for your amazing love.
This is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. This is love. Not that we loved God, but that He loved us and sent His Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins.
Thank you, Father, for your amazing love.
Oh,
the nations tremble. The Lord our God is holy. Great is the Lord. He is exalted over all the nations. Let them praise His great and awesome name.
Our God is holy.
Thank you.
when
the oceans rise and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still, know you are God.
You may take your seats. Our Heavenly Father, we just in awe, even as we think of your greatness, of your power, of your justice, of your love. We just worship you this morning and honor you and glorify you. Lord, we also come to you with humility in our hearts, that after worshiping you and declaring how good and just you are, we cannot help but see ourselves how sinful and dirty is our lives. We humbly come before you and ask for forgiveness. Cleanse us from all the filth that is in our hearts, so that we might be worthy to come to you. We are thankful for your love, for your promise, that if we confess our sins, you're faithful and just to forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Lord, we just claim this promise right now and claim healing and cleansing from our lives. We also come to you, bringing to you our needs. We continue to pray for our brothers and sisters who are in need at this very moment, those who are sick physically, and even those who are sick spiritually. We just come, Lord, and pray that you will touch them with your mighty hand and bring about healing and revival in the hearts of these brothers and sisters. We also come to you asking for your help and comfort for those who are bereaved. Bless them, Lord, with your presence, that it may bring about peace in their hearts and even peace in their minds. Even as we look forward for another church year, we continue to ask for clearer visions, especially on the ministry that the church, that this church is going to do. It is my prayer, Lord, that we'll be truly sensitive to your guidance and leading. Lord, we continue to uphold to you and pray especially for our leaders. I pray, Lord, that you will unite their hearts and minds even as they continue to seek you and honor you and glorify you. We look forward, Lord, for great things to be done through this church here. We also ask that even as we continue to worship you this morning, you will bless us with open hearts and minds, even as we listen to your word. May we honor you and glorify you through all this, and even the songs and the hymns and the anthem of the choir, I pray, Lord, that you will use them mightily to bring about the message you want to convey in our hearts. This is our prayer in the mighty name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Lord, I offer my life to you, everything I've been through. Use it for your
request everyone to please stand as we read the word of the Lord found in the book of Colossians chapter 2 verses 6 to 10. I am reading from the New International Version. It says, "So then, just as you received Jesus Christ as Lord, continue to live in Him, rooted and built up in Him, strengthened in the faith as you were taught, and overflowing with thankfulness. See to it that no one takes you captive through hollow and deceptive philosophy, which depends on human tradition and the basic principles of this world rather than on Christ. For in Christ, all the fullness of the deity lives in bodily form, and you have been given fullness in Christ, who is the head over every power and authority. This is the word of God. You may now take your seats.
Shall dream.
Thank you, choir, for that beautiful song. A great assurance for all of us. Every Christian who is in Christ, nothing can separate you from His love. Well, our theme for this year, as a matter of fact, is deepening our roots. And in the coming months, we'll be expounding on this, deepening our roots in our stewardship, in our mission seal, and other aspects and ministries of our lives. And so this morning, I would like for us to look at the basis of this theme in Colossians chapter 2, verses 6 to 7. When the Apostle Paul wrote about the Christian life, one of the things that he mentioned here is we have to deepen our roots. But you know, not only this metaphor was Paul using, he was intentionally introducing a lot of varieties of powerful metaphors. Ginatawag ko ini pictures of our Christian life. Matahom ini nga butang ato nga pagatunan. In Colossians chapter 6 verses 6 to 10, chapter 2 verses 6 to 10. In this passage, there are at least 5 powerful pictures to help us visualize our Christian life. 5 kalarawan, no? The reason the Bible uses a variety of images to describe who we are in Christ is because ang isa lang ka picture hindi maka-exhaust, no, sang at sang riches kag sang kadalumon sang relationship naton sa Ginoo. So limited ang isa lang ka picture. And so this morning, let me share with you some powerful pictures of our Christian life. Okay? We'll skip with the reading of our text. Let's go directly to the first point. First, in the NIV, it says here, live in Him. But you know, in the New King James Version, and I think the New King James Version correctly captures the meaning of it, when it says, as you receive Jesus as your Lord, so walk in Him. Now, walk in Him. Stay on the right track. The word is peripateo, you know, in Greek, from which we get our word peripatetic. Whenever Paul uses this word, it means to describe a person's lifestyle. Ang iya na lifestyle. So as you receive Jesus as Lord, so walk in Him. Ini naghahambal hanungod sang lifestyle sang isa ka tao. It's like when we say, you got to walk and talk. You got to, we speak of all walks of life. So our life is like a walk. We all start out walking in the wrong direction. As people against God, we start out walking in a different direction. Jesus tells us we are all walking down a wide road. A wide road leading to destruction. But salvation is realizing the offer of eternal life, and we do an about face. We turn around and start going on the opposite direction. And that's what the Bible calls repentance. In order to start walking on our salvation road, we start by receiving Jesus as our Lord and Savior. This is the basic that we share to our during our baptismal class. We accept Him as our Lord, not only as our Savior. And then we keep on walking in faith. It's not always easy, but walking itself involves faith. When you think about it, walking is actually risky, you know? It's a risky business. In order to walk, you have to lean forward until you're beginning to fall. Then in order to catch yourself, you have to place one of your feet forward to regain your balance. Then you do it again. We condition ourselves, but every step requires faith and action. So the idea of walking is a reminder for all of us that we cannot stand still. We must keep on progressing in the Christian life. So, namin natanawat ang atin ko ugalingon, if we are progressing in our Christian life. Being born again is the first step. Then we must take the step of baptism. following the examples of Jesus. And then the step of church membership. We fill up our church membership. We try to understand what's the meaning of our membership and our responsibilities. And then the step of service. Hindi pwede nga maging Kristohanon ka kag mapungko. Mapipipi ka lang sa simbahan, no? Mapungko, mapamati kag mapauli. Kinanglan ka gin mag-alagad sa Ginoo. You have to ask the Lord kung in what area of service you're going to serve Him. And then the step of discipleship. And that is the focus of this church here. Kaya kinanglan i-disciple kita sa isa ka isa. So the walk never ends until Jesus calls us home. The Christian life is not like riding one of those people movers in some airports, no? You must continue to place one foot in front of the other and keep walking in faith and walking in the Spirit. So, walker. The next metaphor is a tree, no? Dig deep to grow tall. Supposedly, but there's a proverb that says, don't change horses in the middle of the stream. Pero amunin ginhibon ay exactly ni San Pablo. He changed metaphor in the middle of the streams of thought. So he goes from walking metaphor to horticultural metaphor, a tree. And then amunin sulat ni San Pablo, you are deeply rooted in him, in Colossians 1:7. This sounds like contradiction. Hindi ba lang ang first game metaphor, dapat kang maglakat, you're moving, no? That implies movement, but in the second, we learn we must be rooted. Sa nasiling natin, no single metaphor can do justice to the richness and variety of Christian life. When Jesus spoke of the parable of the sower, He spoke of some people whose lives are like plants growing in shallow soil. And so when the heat of the sun beat down, meaning when troubles come, the plants withered. For a plant to really thrive, it must have a strong, deep root system. That's why some people wither when adversity comes in their lives, because they are not deeply rooted in Jesus. Some Christians are like tumbleweeds, no? They face the danger Paul described in Ephesians chapter 4 when he spoke of Christians who are blown about every kind of doctrine. We've known Christians who got sucked into every new fad and fashion that comes along. A tumbleweed can become a big plant, but it lacks deep roots. Deep roots in people as well as plants create stability and security. Kabalukan mo kung anong kahoy ang may pinakadalom nga root nga system. Yan ang fig tree. There is a fig tree in South Africa nga ang iyang roots kuno can descend up to 400 feet. 400 feet down into the bedrock. Grabe ang iyang panggamot. The only kind of tree that can survive drought. The only tree that can survive even storms. Trees with roots that tap deep down into the ground. Those deep roots create strength and it also seek out nourishment. Amo man sa Christian life. The only Christian, the only kind of Christian who can survive periods of storms, emotional drought, and those who can are those Christians who can sink deep roots into the nourishment and stability that Christ gives. Among many, ang describes ang salmista. This is the kind of person when he wrote, he is like a tree planted by the rivers of water, which yields fruit in its season and whose leaf does not wither. Whatever he does shall prosper. A walker pictures movements and progress. That's us. A tree represents depth and stability. That's us as well. The next time you look at the big trees, remember, it's just a simple small plant. It started with a small plant, but because of the deep root system, it perseveres. It faces tenacity. It has tenacity, even as it faces storms and drought in life. The next metaphor is a student. A student. Apply what you've learned. Paul changes metaphor again to picture a student. Tanan kita nga Kristohanon should be student sa pulong sang Ginoo. Every Christian should be a student of God's Word. Paul uses this metaphor when he wrote, "Now, do what you've been taught. Quit just studying the subject and start living it." No, sa The Message version. Sakto ni ini na sakto na nga sagi katuon kundi isugudi na sa pag-apply ang imo natun-an. You know, when you're a student in school, you have many subjects and several textbooks. Apang for the Christians, we only need one textbook, and that is the Word of God, that is the Bible. So every worship we have every Sunday, we prayerfully plan its Sunday morning worship experience. Even the songs, no, that we ginakanta ta, ginapangamuyuan ta, ang mensahe, ginapangamuyuan ta. And it is my hope that each time we leave our worship, no, every Sunday morning, nga naka-experience kita, nakabati kita sang kamatuuran that was revealed through the Bible. For some of you, it may have been a long time since you have been carrying your Bible with you and really read it. Asking the Holy Spirit to really reveal the truth that He wants you to know. Siguro ang atong mga Bible, kung isa, aral lang sa atong mga kabinet, no, kag ginayabukan na, o kung napabili-bili ito sa atong salakyan. However, ang pulong sa Ginoo, ara sa atong tupad. As Deuteronomy chapter 10, chapter 30, verse 14 says, "The word is very near you. It is in your mouth and in your heart, so you may obey it." However, simply soaking in God's Word once a week, no? Kaisa lang kabes kada simana, no? Hindi ini makatransform sang aton kabuhi. Ang pulong sang Ginoo, the Word of God is near you. For what reason? For you to obey it. The reason God wants you to be familiar with and learn about the Bible is that so you will make the choice to obey it and put to use in your everyday life. Sa imo trabaho, in your home, and in your relationship. I do not know if you can recall a commercial spoof, no, of the movie Cast Away. Ano naman yung pang sini nga Cast Away? Si Tom Hanks, executive sang FedEx, nga na-stranded sa isa ka isla for a year. Well, the movie ends and the commercial begins with Tom Hanks' character delivering, after nga na-save sa gin-deliver, yagapon atong package, no? Nga na-wash out dito sa ma-island. Gindalaya sa recipient. But you know, in the commercial goes to a step further. Because after nga na-deliver ni Tom Hanks, no, sa recipient, ginpamangkot niya, no, ang recipient niya, "I always wonder what was in the package. Can you please tell me?" No? Sabad sa iya sa recipient, "Nothing actually. Nothing really. Just a satellite phone, GPS locator, fishing rod, water purifier, and some seeds." Well, ang tanan nga kinanglanon niya sa isla para nga mabuhi siya kag mag-locate, ara dito gali sa package. So, you know, as followers of Jesus Christ, everything you need to handle life is already in the Bible. It's all there. But you know, simply carrying it around with you on Sunday morning, hindi na magbago ka makabulig sa imo. You have to open it up, use it. You know, the fullness of Christ is not about filling up your schedule with Bible, with activities and Bible studies, no? Kundi is applying sang imo nga natun-an. So Paul gives us the picture of a student who not only learn God's Word, but also puts what he or he knows into action in his life. Ang next na picture is a fountain. Let his life overflow. Paul wrote in Colossians 2:7, portion of Colossians 2:7, and let your living spill over into thanksgiving. Okay, spill over, overflow. Ano ang implication sa ni? One of the ways in which Jesus personally overflow our lives is by how we talk. No? Makita mo nga nag-overflow si Kristo sa imo kabuhi, isa sa mga indicators ang imo ginapanghambal every day. Hindi lang kung natubang mong Kristohanon, kundi ang adlaw-adlaw mo nga pagkabuhi. Ang imong baba, your mouth is a good indicator of the condition of your heart. No? Just as you can hear a fountain overflowing, you can also identify an overflowing Christian by the sound, by his sound, sa iya ginapanghambal. Listen to them. Mabalaan mo kung anong unod sang inatagipisoon. As Jesus said, out of the overflow of the heart, the mouth speaks. If your heart is full of anger, if your heart is full of bitterness, if your heart is full of filth and dirt, amo man siyang magagwa sa imo baba. But you know, if your heart is filled with Jesus, it will also come out in the way you talk as well. Isa pagitsa namin is a fountain. Not only is a fountain pleasing to the eyes, but it is also pleasing to the ears. So there's just something soothing about the sound of water. No, nga daw, ginagamit gani ini nga therapy. Well, in the way, a Christian who is full of Jesus will be speaking in a way that sounds healing and soothing to others. May mga tao, no, nga kung mag-upod ka sa iya ka magpamati, ganami imo pamatyan. May mga tao man niya, nga kung updan mo, nagaka-depress ka, nga daw, galala pagid ang imo problema. So the message of Colossians is that we don't have to manufacture the Christian life. Amo nang main message sang Colossians. You don't manufacture the Christian life. Jesus lives in us and we simply need to let His supernatural life overflow through us and spill out to others. Overflowing life. If we try to live according to our own strength. Sa ato lang kusog, you want to live your Christian life on your own strength? You will be depleted. Kapuyon kagid. It's like, you know, a flower vase full of water. Nga pag ula mo ay nabilin. No? That's empty. That's the picture of a lot of people who have given out themselves so much. Nga wa ay nasang bilin sa ila. But when you know, when you're full of Jesus Christ, He gives you an unending supply of strength and grace. There's always more. When you think you're depleted, you discover there's more. Jesus just keep giving and giving. What is impossible for us is easily possible with God. As a matter of fact, kung ikaw napunan ni Kristo Jesus, you find He gives you more. Sobra pa sang sa imo kinanglanon. Para nga sabihin, you can keep on helping others and blessing others with your overflow. When you surrender your life to Christ, the hope of glory, you truly understand that the Bible means when it says, my cup runs over. That's an overflowing life. So in this context, the Bible says we should overflow with thankfulness. Ang ginahambal niya diri with thankfulness. So pamangkot siguro sa atin, do you have a thankful spirit? Are you humbly grateful or are you grumbly hateful? The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 5 verse 20, we should give thanks to God the Father for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. One of the greatest commentators of all time was a Puritan named Matthew Henry, you know, and some of those who are studying the theology will nakita nyo ang komentary ni Matthew Henry. You know, once in a while going from church, you know, he was going gapauli na si Matthew Henry. You know, Matthew Henry was accosted by burglars who robbed him. Afterwards, this is what he wrote about that experience, you know, being robbed. Now I am thankful that first, I have never been robbed before. This is the first time. Second, I am thankful that although they took all I had, it wasn't much. Thirdly, I am thankful that they took my money and not my life. And number four, I am thankful that it was I who was robbed and not I who robbed. Na ako lang ikawatan, pag hindi ako ang nagpangawat. Na? That's what I call overflowing with thankfulness sa tanan-tanang butang. See if you can find something to be thankful for in every situation of your life. And then lastly, a soldier. A soldier. Paul switched to a military metaphor when he wrote, "See to it that no one takes you captive." Okay? The word captive was a military term for a prisoner of war. And this military metaphor is used quite often in the New Testament. Paul wrote in Ephesians chapter 6 that we must put on the full armor of God. We're not fighting against flesh and blood, but against spiritual forces of evil. A soldier captured by enemy is no longer in battle. Sadly, there are many believers who are no longer frontline warriors for God. Hindi na mga frontline na warriors sa Ginoo because they have been ambushed by lies of Satan. Mga binutik ni Satan. And Paul warned the believers about this danger when he wrote about, for example, the distracting lie. Paul said in Colossians 2, verse 8, "Watch out for people who try to dazzle you with big words and intellectual double talk. They want to drag you off into endless arguments that never amount to anything." Deception has always been an effective military strategy. You can remember the Trojan horse, when the Greek soldiers hid inside the wooden horse, when the men of Troy mistook that for a peace of offering, and that leads to the capture of Troy. The devil is the master of misdirection. He is the sinister minister of deception. In John chapter 8, verse 44, si Jesus nag-reveal kung sino ang matutuod ng nature ni Satanas. He said, "He is a liar and the father of lies." So, picture Satan smiling whenever he sees Christian arguing about doctrinal differences. Satan laughs every time he sees a church split over some differences in belief. He knows if he can keep the Christian, arguing and fussing with each other, they will never be effective soldiers. Malipatan nila ang ila primary work, and that is to evangelize and to disciple. Dira sila ma-focus sa ila argument. But the Bible teaches the Christian life is not about the set of belief, it's about a person. And that also leads us, isa pagin, the liberating truth. Everything of God gets expressed in Christ, so you can see and hear Him clearly. Sugpo niya, you don't need a telescope, a microscope, or a horoscope to realize the fullness of Christ and the emptiness of the universe without Him. When you come to Him, the fullness comes together for you too. No? Fullness is the theme of Colossians. Without Jesus Christ, our lives are empty. But in Christ, we find fullness of God and we can experience the wonderful fullness. So based on this portion of God's word, we should keep on walking in faith. We should be like a tree and allow our roots to keep sinking deeper and deeper into Jesus. We are all students and we'll never stop learning. But we need to be using what we've learned, apply it. We should be like fountains of water, constantly overflowing with thankfulness. And as soldiers of Christ, we must be on guard against the deception of the enemy. No? This is a beautiful picture of the Christian life because they remind us of how exciting it is to follow Jesus. You know, Christian life hindi boring. It is an exciting thing to follow Him. No? There's a cute poem that says, you listen to this poem. There was a very cautious man who never laughed or played. He never risked, he never tried, he never sung or prayed. And when he one day passed away, his insurance was denied. For since he never really lived, they claim he never died. People don't understand. The Bible often been thinking as Christians, a Christian life is a boring life. No, it's wrong. The most thrilling and the most exciting experience in the universe is being a Christian. You don't really start living until you meet Jesus. Jesus who said, I've come that they might have life and live it to the fullest. So amo na ang Christian life. It is my prayer that as we start with this new church year, we will go deeper into the Bible, deeper into our relationship with Jesus Christ, and continue to grow in Him. So God bless you.
Yours, O Lord, are the greatness, the power, the glory, the victory, and the majesty. For all that is in the heavens and on the earth is yours. Yours is the kingdom, O Lord, and you are exalted as head above all.
My strength, my song, this cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace. When fears are stilled, when striving cease, my comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in hell, that's made this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. On that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid, here in the death of Christ I live. There in the ground his body lay, light of the world by darkness lay, then bursting forth in glorious day, oh, the ring he rose again, and as he stands in victory, since curse has lost its grip on me, precious blood of Christ. Alleluia.
No guilt in life, no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man, can ever pluck me from his hand.
Till he returns, calls me home, here in the power of Christ I stand.
Here in the power of Christ I stand.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, from whom comes all that is good, we praise you for your mercies, for your goodness that has created us, your grace that has sustained us, your discipline that has corrected us, your patience that has borne with us, and your love that has redeemed us. Help us to love you and to be thankful for all your gifts by serving you. Amen.
Now, before we partake of our communion, we're so happy to extend our right hand of fellowship to our newly baptized members, mga young people in you know? We're so happy to have them. I hope God is letting them in. Although some of them are worshiping in our Vesper service. But anyway, may I call on Bert Jerome Lapian. Is Bert here? And why is Bert? L.J. Chris Lockup. Okay, some of them are in duty, you know. Roland John Vinson. Roland John Vinson, would you please come? Di ba kuya uya, no? Nara? Okay. Si Mary White Vinson. Dali na kuya, sila ba si Gina? Dawari sila kung nahina? Sige. May ask them to please come. Hindi, Mary, ipakadwa sa front. Hindi sila mahuya. Si Roland, si Mary White. Okay. And also may I call on Janiel Duliano. Janiel. Apo ni Saninong Tone, kay Ipang, no? Si Janiel. Okay. And then Ruel John Duliano. Dulano, para si John Vincent, si Mary Jane, si Mary White, si Janiel Araman. You stay, napabilin ka mo for a while. Okay, kamusta ang pagkamusta ng mga deacons? Okay, si Janiel, si Ruel, si Janiel, may ibang deacons, can you please help? No? Si Harvey John Pinyafield. Si Harvey John, okay. Sir Vijan Peñafil Arasa. And then also, Kenny Dion Peñafil. Si John Rick Vinson. Yes, John Rick. Okay, ang iban, may duty, ang iban sa Vesperga Worship, and brothers and sisters in the Lord, these are newly baptized young people. Please include them in your prayers that they will grow in the relationship with the Lord. And they will continue on serving the Lord. Okay, so the Board of Deacons, you can now go and extend a handshake of fellowship to our newly baptized. Thank you.
of my death until I come.
Please rise for the reading of our church covenant. Begin. Having been led by the Spirit of God to profess our faith in Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, and having been baptized in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, we do now solemnly and joyfully affirm our covenant with God and with one another. We pledge to serve Christ in the fellowship of this congregation. We shall endeavor to love one another, to remember one another in prayer, to share in each other's joys, and to sustain one another in times of distress. We aspire to be a fellowship of the concerned, where the lost may find Jesus Christ, sinners may find pardon, seekers may find meaning for their lives, and where all who come may find welcome. We shall strive to be responsible church members through faithful attendance, study, service, and giving. We shall seek to be obedient to Christ in our daily living, and we shall strive for attitudes and actions which will reflect our God Spirit working through us in all our relationships with people. Believing that our bodies are temples of the Holy Spirit, we shall endeavor to avoid experiences and habits which defile the body and hinder our witness. Bound together in the fellowship of faith with all who confess Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, we shall pray and labor for a spirit of unity among Christians, believing that our call to the church is a call to witness in the world. We dedicate ourselves anew as servants of the Lord of all life. We shall strive for justice, freedom, dignity, and peace for all men, and to be ministers of God's reconciling love. We further pledge our support to our missionaries who witness with us to the Lordship of Jesus Christ throughout the world. Acknowledging our human frailties and ever seeking forgiveness, we profess our need of the Holy Spirit and commit our lives to Jesus Christ and through Him to the care, the judgment, the deliverance, and mercy of Almighty God. Amen.
May you take your seats. What we celebrate with the Lord's table is not our worthiness, but that of Jesus Christ. He welcomes all who come constrained by love and seeking their lives more worthy of Him. That worthiness that should forbid our coming to the Lord's table consists in having wrong motives. If we do not think of what we're doing, if we have no intention of carrying out the promise we give, if we are consciously living in sin, it is clear we have no right to come. To all who want better, on the other hand, Christ says, come. So on the night in which He was betrayed, Jesus took the bread, and when He had given thanks, He gave it to them and said, take, eat, this is my body broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In like manner, He also took the cup and again gave thanks. And giving it to His disciples, He said, This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. For the bread and for the cup, may I ask Mr. Fernandez to pray for us.
Let us pray. Almighty God and loving Heavenly Father, we always take great pleasure in celebrating this communion because we feel and we know, Father, that this is the only time that we can remember with our whole attention about how the Lord Jesus Christ sacrificed for our salvation. Lord, thank you so much that you have sent your only Son, Jesus, for us to be saved from eternal damnation. And so as we commemorate this important occasion in our spiritual life, Father, we pray that you'll bless and anoint these elements. The bread representing his body and the cup representing his blood for the remission of our sins. Lord, we pray that as we partake of these elements, your Holy Spirit will go through our lives, Father, that we may know more about you, the Lord Jesus Christ, and not only know you, but above all, Lord, believe in you and follow your commands. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
I'm ministering in Christ's name. I now give you this bread and this cup. For this bread is a symbol of Christ's broken body for the redemption of the world. Let us eat together and remember Him. This cup is a symbol of the spilled blood of Jesus for the salvation of the world. Let us drink together and remember Him. Amen. Before we sing our closing hymn, our theme song for this year, we have some announcements. We would like to remind the adult Sunday school teachers, you know, to stay for a while for your evaluation and retreat. So teachers for Sunday school adults. And also would like to announce our prayer meeting this coming Wednesday will be sponsored by the Maykagan Circle. You know? Members of the Maykagans, please be reminded of this. And also, June 5, sa EMC, will be the book launching of the book Rescue. No? This is written by Oliver Almonares. Oliver was a alumni, no, sa Aton High School. Members ng PMA's 96. Siya ni ang nag-head sa troop na nag-rescue sa kay sa missionary sa Palawan. Sa El Nido, sa Thornham, ng couple. And he was a strong believer right now and a follower of our Lord Jesus Christ. And this book, he relates his experience, no? And his whole platoon in how they encountered the Lord and how the Lord had helped them. So EMC, January 5, 9 o'clock. No? June 5, EMC. Okay, so these other announcements are here in the church bulletin. So let us now sing our closing hymn, our theme song for this month, May the Mind of Christ, our Savior, even as we also give our benevolence offering, which we use for our sick brethren and for those who are bereaved. Let's also return our empty cups.
Oh,
Him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you before His glorious presence without fault and with great. To the only God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, power, and authority through Jesus Christ, through all ages, now and forevermore. Amen.